Multiple stabbings. One of the orderlies had a finger bitten off.
If you're looking for who to blame, maybe start with the mirror, because you're the one that left violent psychotics unattended.
Exactly. Mr. Wayne, I understand you have been through a trying day, but that does not give you the freedom to criticize me or this facility in that way. Because from my perspective, my patients were fine until you went into that rec room today. One moment. Seems you have a visitor.
Oh. Is that Brett?
Alfred.
Ah, Bruce. Thank heavens you're all right. You see, everything is in order. Signed this morning with Lieutenant Gordon of the GCPD. He is to be released into my care.
I know it seems like using your power and influence is the best way to make this all go away. But it's just avoiding the problem. What happened with those men in your room? The riot with Zaz? You clearly need help, Bruce. He needs extensive evaluation, treatment.
Dr. Leland, you know it isn't safe for me here. Look at what happened today. That won't be the last time.
That may be true, but I would never let that hinder someone from getting the help they need.
I'm afraid it's out of your hands now, Doctor. You have the paperwork.
Let's go, Alfred.
Bye, Joker.
I will see you on the outside, Bruce.
I can't wait!
What was that about?
Crazy.
I can't believe that Lady Arkham was actually Vicky Vale this entire time.
And all the while she was working with Cobblepot to try and bring me down.
Did Lieutenant Gordon hear about this lead when he let you out?
Not yet. Batman will handle this one first.
Even during Batman's brief hiatus, Gotham has become that much more dangerous. And the public opinion on Bruce Wayne... Well, it... certainly hasn't gotten any better.
So many people angry at me. The entire family. I just hope I can turn it around.
Make that choice.
Sure you'll figure something out. You always do.
Selina?
Well, good to know Miss Kyle's keeping in touch from wherever she is now.
In other news, if you've noticed, the streets of Gotham have been a lot quieter recently.
You're not alone. Yeah.
The GCPD has reported a sudden and steep drop in violent crime in the past few days, with the number of 911 calls falling off a whopping 60%. Many are attributing it to the decrease in the visibility of the terrorist group Children of Arkham, whose members seem to be taking some time off. Or maybe it's just our new Mayor Dent making good on his campaign promise to bring down crime in the city. Either way, the citizens are breathing a sigh of relief.
Aww.
Hello, Harvey.
You should have stayed in the asylum where I put you.
What do you want, Harvey?
The streets of Gotham are a dangerous place for someone like you right now. Well, you'll figure that out. Eventually.
Just leave me the hell alone, Harvey. Trust me, it'll be easier for you in the long run.
I was doing you a favor, Bruce. If you want to get ugly, well, that can be arranged. Oh. Maybe you haven't heard, but the Children of Arkham have gone underground. Obviously plotting some sort of attack, and people are scared, panicking. I needed to show them that my resolve hasn't weakened, that Gotham is still strong. So I gave them an enemy. You and your family's filthy corruption. The last thing I need is you traipsing around Gotham.
You're pathetic, Harvey. Not even mayor for a week, and already the pressure's gotten to you.
Two-Face will remember
that. What the hell? I'm just a man who's done letting assholes like you run the world and take whatever they want. Can't let you keep running around scot-free, Bruce. It's the will of the people.
You can spare me your will of the people crap, Harvey. I know this is personal.
You knew I was interested in Selena. What you did was a low blow, Bruce. A real man wouldn't have done that. A friend wouldn't have done that.
She doesn't belong to you, Harvey. She can see whoever she wants. Yeah,
do not lecture me about Selena. Bruce? Bruce!
We're done talking.
Shit.
What's going on here?
About to be some action.
Well, Bruce Wayne. You really must have done something to piss the mayor off so much, hmm? Maybe I'll get a bonus for this. Open the trunk. We're searching the car. If we find anything tying you to the Children of Arkham, including drugs, weapons, or any other suspicious materials, you will be taken into custody.
Go ahead. I have nothing to hide.
Doesn't sound like it. Besides, everyone's hiding something.
Come on, what's the damn holdup?
Get back to your car!
Of course. Should've known. Go back to Arkham, you damn maniac!
The hell?
Careful, or you'll be the next Cobblepot.
Showing your face in public like this? Not real smart.
I'm in trouble. I am tired, I am hungry, I haven't showered in 3 days! I want to go home, and if you don't get the hell out of my way, I swear to God, I will have this car run you over, and then back up again, just to make sure it did the job!
God,
Bruce,
damn, bro.
Shut up, Alfred, I can handle this! Someone else heard that, right? This psycho just threatened me!
Yeah, I filmed the whole thing!
I swear, this is how people...
They should lock you up!
Oh, God.
Bet you if I go outside and be like that...
Alfred,
I'm sorry. Do dumbass shit like that.
I don't...
You'll be
oh
fine.
Oh my God, no.
We just need to get out of
That's
this
what I'm
mess.
Telling you.
Nowhere to run, dirtbag!
Imagine being treated like
shit.
That's what
won't be a warning shot!
When you're out there in the streets
right.
like that.
The way I see it, there are two ways we can do this, Bruce Wayne. Either I let these people at you and see how you handle mob justice, or you could make a little donation to me and my boys to help us stay well-funded, hmm? And well-armed?
Oh my God.
What do you say?
Just give you bread?
They've got us blocked in. I can't back up. This is turning ugly,
give
sir.
Give them bread, whatever.
What would you like to do?
Hey, the mayor's gonna hear about this, and it ain't gonna make him happy.
Yeah, whatever, here. Pay. Here, whatever.
It's everything I
Fuck
have.
Fuck off.
Okay.
Sure, that'll work.
This isn't over.
I don't want to destroy
the
car or anything.
Take it up with City Hall.
It's already fucked up. Not trying to have no fight. No problems, bro. Take the bread, go. I thought nowadays people just want money. Just give it to them. Fuck it. If you want to fight back for it. But I might end up getting killed anyways.
Just get us home, Al. Fast. Computer.
You're exhausted, and the influence of Lady Arkham's drug may still be affecting you.
Harvey is turning Gotham into a police state. Oswald has stolen my company, and we need to find Vicky and the Children of Arkham before they strike again. I can't just ignore it.
You're in no condition to work. You absolutely must get some rest.
I'm gonna say, help me, Dan. Help me.
It feels like the whole damn cave is coming down around me.
Of course I'll help. Let's start by addressing the problem at hand.
Bruce, you look awful.
He's had a very long evening.
You're right. Let's just focus on getting my head clear first. Bring up everything we know about Vicky Vale's drug.
I'm on it.
So,
if we can isolate the presence
of
the drug, I should be able to synthesize an antidote.
Couldn't you just,
let's start with the DNA scan. Compare it to your DNA on file in the back computer.
I'll make the preparations.
So he couldn't just like go to, so he couldn't just like, so you don't have anything to like go into your system, take all of that blood out or something like that. Well, DNA, well, there you go. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. DNA clean. Well, let me see. Let's examine.
This is the refined sample of the drug taken from Officer Montoya after she killed Falcone.
Oh, this is how you DNA sample. Let me see.
Here's my DNA before the incident. It seems that the drug attaches itself to specific proteins in the genome structure. If we can modify the drug's molecular structure, we should be able to create a counteragent.
Once you've figured this out, we'll have a working antidote.
Oh my God,
we can cure others affected by the drug.
No. I wish that were possible.
It's based on the individual's DNA. We'd have to sample and decode the genome structure for each and every person to make them a cure.
We don't have the time or resources for that.
Dude.
That's why we were lucky to have mine on file already.
I don't even know, bro. Oh. I don't even know. I had to cheat. Okay, there we go. Got it. All right, good.
That should do it.
Okay, what am I doing?
This needs to be injected directly into the vein to work.
I don't imagine it'll be
Jesus
much fun.
Christ, what? Everyone got you syringe every single time. Oh, I gotta do it. No. Oh. God damn. Okay, man. Get rid of that. Oh.
Hopefully that does the trick.
It'll work.
Like, if within a month, I gotta go to the dentist.
What are we going to do now?
I gotta.
First things first, I need to know what Vicky, Lady Arkham, has been up to while I've been away.
Oh my God, I hate that.
Search for all children of Arkham recent activity.
That is my biggest fear.
The press is reporting that Vicky Vale is missing.
Yes, and obviously the police have yet to find a body.
My God, I see
that
needle too much.
Trying to get the scoop on you, pretending to care. She betrayed you.
No, trust her, child.
She's a monster. To do what she did.
She has no sense of morality.
She was playing me the entire time, breaking me down. She wanted me in Arkham. She wanted me to feel what my father had done to all those people.
She wants you in Arkham.
Bruce.
There were bigger plans than me, Alfred. Batman stopped her at the Skyrail station, and I can't believe that she isn't finding another way to use the drugs.
Well, if that's true, she may be more dangerous than ever.
I know. I met someone in Arkham who gave me a tip on how to find her.
A tip? Do you really think you can trust someone in Arkham Asylum? Offense intended toward your recent time there, of course.
He knew that Vicky Vale was Lady Arkham.
Yeah.
No one else has that information.
I suppose that's not something we can ignore, trustworthy or not.
He told me that if I want to know what she's planning, then I should visit her parents' house.
Shouldn't be too tough to locate her.
Got it.
Bruce, before you head out, I've got something for you. I call it a strobe grenade. Throw it at any surface and the ensuing light show will make you almost impossible to track.
Perfect. Thank you, Lucius.
Thank you. Least I can do after you invited me to come work in the Batcave with you.
Bruce!
Yeah?
If you do find Miss Vale, please,
Be careful.
Damn. You can see him put on the clothes. Gotham Heights. Vale residence.
I'm inside the Vale House.
About to be action time, because he knows Batman. Unless he's just doing detective shit. That's her parents?
Alfred, the Vales are dead. One body confirmed, but there is a lot of blood. Alert Gordon.
Will do.
I don't know how this is connected to the drugs yet. Whatever they knew about it, Vicky made sure they kept quiet. Syringe. Seems she hasn't given up her old tricks.
Is this the same drug?
God damn it.
Yes. But this is several times stronger than the dosage I received.
Maybe she's escalating.
This seems personal.
Like, dog, I just want to go to the dentist and get over that shit. Okay, can we search your body, please? Don't just hit that. Jesus fucking Christ.
Her eyes are gone. Stabbed out.
That's disturbing.
There's an injection wound on her neck. Same kind Montoya and I both received, but this one's much worse.
I'm getting too old to see, like, nasty shit, man.
Recent family photo?
Vicky's not in it. It shows the Vales with another child like in front of an industrial office. There's a logo on the building.
That's fucked up. Maybe you shouldn't say that.
Large amounts of blood spatter across the walls. It's not steady like arterial spray. Someone was swinging wildly. Wait. There's a slight indentation where something bloody struck the wall with force.
Something thrown.
Nothing I can see.
The steak. Ooh. Damn. I'm missing out on a good meal. Gimme. Not the steak. Hair.
I found a lock of hair.
Anything unique about it?
It was cut at a downward angle, probably with some force based on how clean the slice is.
Attempt to kill, but
it's
failed.
It's clean. This wasn't used as a murder weapon.
Then why was it lying on the floor?
Attempt to kill, but failed. Is that blood on the... No.
Alfred found Mr. Vale.
Alive.
Himself,
no.
Yeah. Probably just killed himself.
He's gone.
So. Fuck it!
10 hours at least, judging by the state of his soft tissues. Looks like a company logo. The belt buckle is covered in blood. Before he was hung with the belt, Mr. Vale was beaten with it.
Oh, okay. So he wasn't hanged. That made it seem like he did. Food. Oh, there's a lot of... Okay. Damn. Holy shit. All right. Oh, God damn it, bro. Wait, there was a circle button on this. But...
Same device, same drug. This confirms that Lady Arkham is the murderer.
I'm checking. Okay. So I guess that would be Dad? Oh, it's the picture. Okay.
The logos match. Mr. Vale owned an oil and heating company.
Looking it up now. Yes, he's got a sizable warehouse in the industrial district and a fleet of delivery trucks.
And now Vicky's got it.
I'm walking all the way over here. Oh, damn. syringe. No, I already scanned it. Hair and what? I guess knife. Or maybe cut.
It appears Mrs. Vale attempted to fight back with this knife.
Failed.
It only managed to slice through the attacker's hair.
What else? Am I missing something? Maybe it's her belt now. Oh.
The indentation matches the shape of the belt buckle. It must have impacted with the wall during the attack.
What exactly happened in that house?
So she used
I think I know.
Maybe.
After we stopped her at the rail station, Vicky needed a place to hide her supply of drugs. Her father's trucks and warehouse offered the perfect cover. To do that, she needed them out of the way. With Vicky Vale fully assuming her new identity of Lady Arkham, seems like she didn't need the Vales around to support her old one. Vicky showed up to attack her adopted parents, but only the mother was there at first. Miss Vale fought back and was able to slice off part of Vicky's hair. Vicky then subdued her with the same drug she used on me, but a much, much larger dose. Nearly lethal. She then removed the mother's eyes, indicating a deeply personal motivation. This was obviously some sort of vendetta.
Oh, damn.
Sometime during this, Mr. Vale entered. Vicky attacked him with his own belt, striking with the buckle until he was unconscious and bleeding out. Finally, she dragged him to the closet and hung him with the belt. The blood loss got him way before the hanging did.
Well, that's horrific. She never acted out in such a violent way before. Why would she...
Alfred, I think someone's still in the house, going to look for a heat signature. If anyone else is here, I'll find them. Clear. Nothing here.
Anything?
No. There's someone here, under the stairs,
the fuck?
Alive.
Oh, he's probably, probably traumatized, you know. Yeah, super traumatized. I think I saw everything that happened. I'm scared. Batman. Who the fuck are you?
It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
Sir, is everything all right?
It's a kid, Alfred. The boy from the photo.
Is he all right?
Aside from the shock and a few bruises, he seems okay. He might be able to tell me more about what happened.
Possibly. But if that's the road you go down, please do it with caution.
I need to know what happened.
No!
Tell me what you saw.
Go away!
I'm sorry I scared you. It's going to be okay.
Yeah?
I need you to tell me if you saw or heard anything. This is important.
I heard someone say something. Something about drugs? Fighting the police? I don't know who. I don't know who because I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything because they're hidden here. Please don't send me to punishment.
Calm down. See, that does help me. Thank you.
Get down!
Well, hello, Batman. What a pleasure to see you.
Oh, that's terrible.
Let me guess.
You probably
You're
found
trying
the,
to figure out our next move. Figure out where the drugs are. Did I get it? Emma goes. Pathetic. I've got these little bat traps all over the city. But I should have known a good double murder would be what brought you out in the open.
Nice work, kid.
I'm gonna say it was stupid. He tried.
They're dead.
It'll be better if you don't look.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
They weren't always nice, but they gave me a place to live.
I promise. I won't stop until I catch the person that did this. You're the kid who saved Batman. And no matter what happens, no matter where you go, that will always be true. And I will always owe you one.
Batman!
Oh my
God. I killed them all.
He was the only survivor.
Come on. Let's get you out of here.
He saved me.
Oh, Jesus. Was this the Children of Arkham? Again? Why would they attack a family like the Vales?
Because their daughter, Vicky, is Lady Arkham. She killed her own parents so she could use their company warehouse to stockpile the rest of her drugs.
Vicky? Vicky Vale, the reporter? And so, who was the boy then?
My guess is he's another foster child living with the Vales. He says he heard something about drugs and attacking the police. Can't confirm anything, but it sounds like the Children of Arkham might be plotting something with those drugs against your people.
Thanks for the heads up.
The warehouse is Vale Oil and Heating. You should secure it as soon as possible.
I'll get on it right away. What about you?
I've got something I need to look into.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
Securing the crime scene, Commissioner.
Uh-oh, Batman, it's like that piece of shit.
I'm taking over this investigation.
What?
I can't risk you allowing Batman to contaminate our crime scene again.
Damn. Home?